am originally from Kenya, so I came here on a Fulbright scholarship, and it has been an experience of a lifetime, to be honest, and I'm very happy to be in the University of Toledo community. My research focus is mostly in vascular biology, whereby we study the vascular dysfunctional effects of in different disease states, for instance, hypertension, diabetes, sepsis. And so we normally try to see how different disease states, different cardiovascular diseases affect the vascular function of the body or the vascular physiology.
I was born and raised in Toledo, Ohio. Right now, I'm studying Alzheimer's disease and the effects of exercise capacity. My project is looking at how exercise capacity affects neurocognition and Alzheimer's disease. Animal handling is one of the biggest techniques I use because I work with rats on a daily basis. However, secondary techniques would involve dissection, blood draw, stuff like that, cell culture, RT-PCR, ELISA. So all over the board, we do all different kinds of laboratory techniques.
On a daily basis, you will find me on the wire myograph, which is their like isometric equipment, which normally mimic the physiology of the human body. And so we try to test for vascular function using wire myography as a technique. And also you will find me doing skills like genotyping and Western blots and, you know, such techniques within the lab. On a good day with full of experiments, I'll probably spend about 6 hours on the bench. In the lab, I spend like a whole day, but then while running my experiments, 6 to 7 hours a day.
3 to 4 hours, depending on the project. For dissection, they can take a long time. Ultimately, they could be a little bit time intensive. I'm usually in the lab probably, when we have a full day going, I'm in the lab probably from about 9 o'clock till about 4 or 5 o'clock.
And once I'm out of this lab, that is me time. So once I get out of the campus, I switch off my schoolwork and I take up my me time.
I have a rule with my personal life that when I am done with all my work, we are done and we're done thinking about it. And that's my way of kind of keeping myself sane, because science can bog you down mentally, and it's important to watch your mental health, especially when you're studying this stuff.
We were slowed down when we went on lockdown. After lockdown, I had to really rush through the research, the experimental aspect of my work, so that I tried to catch up on the lost time. At the same time, COVID has affected us in terms of our mental health and, you know, emotionally. So I feel like my physical, mental, and emotional energy has been drained, and that kind of slows you down on the research aspect as well.
With animal modeling, a lot of this stuff becomes time intensive, and we had to really step back and really mitigate a lot of those damages before we could continue and go forward with our project. So that put us back about 4 or 5 months in the planning and in my project specifically.
What would I tell anybody who wants to visit Toledo? I would tell them it's a very serene place. Toledo as a community is very relaxed, very welcoming. The people here are very understanding. And there's a lot of diversity in the Toledo community, whether in on campus or off campus. So you get to meet people from all walks of life, and it's a very good interaction and a very good experience.
Toledo is an awesome place. There's always people here who will find you and be helpful for you and be helpful towards you and ultimately want to see you succeed. Yes, I am very happy with my decision so far to come to Toledo.
It has been a very insightful experience. I have to say, from my background, it has been a very rigorous curriculum, very advanced technology, very, very happy people as well. So I am very glad with the outcome that I've experienced from this university. And I would advise anybody who wants to experience it to come along.